Aki Kareem for British Boxers, and today we are in Nottingham, my hometown actually, and I'm joined by Carwin Herbert. We're at Javed Khalid's Boxing Academy. Carwin, how are you doing, man?
I'm good, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good, man. It's really good to see you because, you know, you've been sending and writing articles for British Boxers for quite a while, haven't you?
Yeah, I've been done a few for you.
Yeah, good articles as well. You know, when we read them, we think, you know, you really know your boxing, love your boxing.
Yeah, well, for a few years I've been getting boxing news every week. Got into boxing back in 2002 watching Byron Mitchell against Joe Calzaghe.
Oh, yeah. You went down that fight, didn't you, Calzaghe?
Yeah, that was the first fight I ever watched. Up until then, growing up in Wales, you always watched rugby and football, terrible football team until recent years. And then I heard about this British boxer who was unbeaten from Wales. Tuned in and watched it and was hooked ever since.
Yeah, yeah. Well, let's talk about, you know, the fact that you're from Wales. I mean, from near Carmarthen.
Yeah.
What does a man from near Carmarthen, you know, how does he end up in Nottingham?
I started boxing down in a gym called Cardigan ABC back in, I think, around 2007, 2008-ish. Yeah. And come 2009, I realised that the prospects of doing well in boxing in that area of the country wasn't too good, considering that there was no local pro shows or anything like that on. So I decided to relocate. Mm. And number one on my list of relocation was Manchester.
Yes.
So I'd looked at Boxing Monthly, looked down the back, I looked at the rankings, and I looked to see which area had the most people there, and I thought, well, that's a good boxing scene there. Mm. And then I started seeing a woman who was going to go to university in Nottingham. She persuaded me to come here for a week to see what it was like. I came to Jav's gym to trial it. Ironically, on the same week that the gym opened. Liked it, and then I moved up a few weeks later, and I've been here ever since.
Wow, yeah, so you've been here at Javed Khalid's Boxing Academy, and of course, that is in Nottingham, you know, you can't really find anyone better in terms of like someone who's been there and done it. You know, he's a former IBO world champion, he's in the boxing trade, he's very well respected. So, did you have an instant sort of, did you get on well and sort of enjoy the training with Javed Khalid?
Yeah, it was brilliant at the start. Absolutely, and it's been good ever since. I mean, the first week I was in the gym, the first week there was a grand opening and so on, and by the second week it was Ramadan, so there wasn't high numbers there, so it was like getting a full month of one-to-one tuition for free, or for the gym subs. So I advanced a lot in that first month, and then I felt like we got on good. I was progressing really quickly, so I felt this was a place for me.
Yeah, yeah. And you're four fights in now.
Yep.
To your pro career, how have you sort of found the initial sort of forage into the professional game?
I've really enjoyed it so far. Besides you've got the rigors of dieting and ticket selling, which every pro kind of gets caught up about, but it's part of the game, and we knew about it before we got in it. First two fights went really well. I didn't lose a round. Third fight, lost two rounds, meaning I lost the fight. It was coming off about a year and a half to 2 years of inactivity, and I just wasn't at the races that day. And then I got back to winning ways 2 weeks ago, and won the fight quite clearly. So looking to get back out end of June.
What weight are you fighting at?
I'm looking to get down to welterweight, but right. My last fight was just under the middleweight limit, so I'm gradually bringing it down.
So you're trying to get down to 147 pounds?
Yeah.
Ish.
Yeah. Over time.
Over time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, let's talk about the scene in Nottingham then, the boxing scene, because you mentioned there that you moved from Wales over to Nottingham, you ended up settling in. Now, Nottingham has produced some great fighters, but in terms of the boxing scene, it's still some way to go, isn't there, before the scene is like known as a real fight city. So what are your experiences of the actual scene in Nottingham in terms of boxing?
When I first moved here, it was brilliant. You had Jason Booth, who was British champion at the time, Frotchy was world champion, and you had a few other people just below that, such as Adnan Amar, being English champion. And then once Frotchy got to a point where he was headlining Wembley and the MEN Arena, it went a bit dead. And there wasn't much of a boxing scene here at that time. And people from Nottingham were having to fight in different cities and sell tickets, where people had to travel 40-odd miles to go and see him. But it's just recently coming back, having a resurgence again. So it's people like Echo Esserman, who was on the GB squad. He's gone pro, so I think he's 7 or 8-0 now. Lee Woods fighting for an English title soon. And you've got Derek Osaza, Siraj Ahmed, Nathan Kirk. You've got a whole host of fighters who are just turning pro or getting to a point in the pro where they could be fighting for titles. And it's just it's just waiting for one of them to step over that mark with a fight for title before we've got big shows back here, I think. I think someone, one of the big promoters might be keeping an eye on it. I know Echo's signed to Frank Warren, and Lee has fought on a few matchroom shows and impressed. So I think if either of those get snapped up and shows get run here, I think it would provide loads of opportunities for the rest of us to fight on them.
Yeah, well, actually, similar sort of things happening in Newcastle at the minute, isn't it? Because you've had Josh Kelly and Lewis Ritson who have sort of come onto the scene, and actually that might mean that Eddie Hearn takes some fights to Newcastle. And, you know, by the sounds of it, well, hopefully, touch wood, we started getting some pro boxing in Nottingham, some of the big shows. At the minute, in terms of Harvey Haddon's a good place for the boxing, isn't it?
Yeah, it's got a capacity of 2,000.
Yeah.
And then we've got a host of little places like Britannia Hotel, Bingham Leisure Centre, and so on. But Harvey Haddon's historically good. I mean, we can all dream that we can fight at the arena someday. I think it's got about an 8,000 capacity, which is a quite good capacity. If they get, you know, you could get some of the Nottingham fighters, and if they just put one of one big name fighter on it, such as a Billy Joe or a Terry Flanagan or someone like that,
then
it wouldn't struggle to sell out, I don't think.
Yeah. Talking of struggling to sell out, I mean, talk to us about ticket sales and all that sort of stuff, because that is part of being a professional fighter. You know, these days it's not always about who's the best fighter, it can be about popularity and selling tickets and that. And you said, you know, you actually used to sell quite a few good tickets in you know, and if you fought in Wales, you probably would sell quite a few, but how'd you get around that, fighting away from home and selling tickets?
I mean, for me, I've been up here since 2009, so with that, I've kind of established a lot of good friendships here, and this gym's very busy in the evening, so it gets 30 to 40 people, and with me training there, I get a lot of these guys coming down to support me. I work in the day, so people from work come and so on, and then I've done bits and bobs outside work, such as volunteering, and people from that come to try and support you. Can't stress enough how important ticket sales are to the people. I don't think the people that buy the tickets realise how important it is, or that they're actually supporting you, and without the ticket sales that you wouldn't be fighting. But if I fought down Southwest Wales, I'd probably sell quite a bit, and it takes a big burden off me because I can just hand them over to my mum or sister and they sell them on my behalf, whereas up here I've got to do the training, the dieting and running around after gym to sell tickets. But I've got people that help me. My girlfriend sells tickets for me as well. She's running around with them, and she takes a bit huge burden off me, and she helps me with my diet by cooking a lot of the food.
That's handy. Good people of Nottingham though, aren't they, really?
Took me a while to understand some of the lingo. And a cob. My only experience of a cob was either a horse, which is like it's a Welsh cob, or corn on the cob, and I'd be walking around seeing cob shops and I'm like, what the hell are these people on?
You can't beat a good cob though, Carwin, you know. Let's talk a little bit about when you're next out then, you know, who you're with currently, promotional wise, manager wise, and where we could see you in action.
Yeah, so my trainer at the moment, he's training me from this gym, Fidel Castro Smith. He used to train Jawi Khalik, so I'm in good hands there. My manager, Scott Kalo, so he's taken reins over from Jason McCrory last year. Scott's managed me well so far. I've got a good relationship with Scott. One fight under Scott so far, one win. He's looking to get me back out on I don't know the exact date, but end of June. I think he's going through some things now where he's trying to get some promotional things in place, and hopefully I'll be fighting end of June in and around Nottingham. So if that does come off, I'd like everyone to come out and support me.
Yeah, you heard that right. Get behind Carwin, come out and support him, man. It's just a good job it's not on June the 9th, because we just had that announcement Tyson Fury's back. I know you're a fan of Tyson Fury. What do you make of that for the heavyweight division?
I think it opens it up again. Without Tyson Fury, there'd be no Joshua, there'd be no Deontay Wilder, there'd be no Joseph Parker. We wouldn't have got that unification last week. Tyson Fury took the belts off the man in Germany, in his backyard. He went there, he opened up the division. I don't care what anyone says, you know, until Joshua beats Fury, he ain't the man.
Well, you've just made some extra fans there from Manchester.
Yeah.
All right, Carwin, listen, it's been great catching up with you. Really, really good. And you know, we should do this more often, mate.
Yeah, can I give a shout out to my sponsors?
Go for it.
Okay, just want to give a shout out to the sponsors. I've got National Maintenance. They're based in Nottingham. They used to be Nottingham Maintenance, and they've just been they just do maintenance around the house with building contractors and so on. I've got Inspire Painting Contractors, self-explanatory. If you get in touch with them, they can do painting for your house or for big buildings. Got the fitness kitchen. They deliver food to my door, which has been a big help in helping me lower and maintain my weight. So if anybody wants to get their weight down or get just eat, generally eat healthier, you can get in touch with them. And just finally, ID Williams Garage in Llanabyfyr in Wales. So if you want your MOTs or anything done to your car, you can get down there.
Great to see you, Carwin. Appreciate your time. Aki Kareem, British boxers, you know the score. Power.